Hello everybody, today we are going to move on our lectures on frequency response techniques and feedback control systems. In the first two lectures, we learned how to draw polar and Nyquist plots, and then we learned how to apply Nyquist stability analysis for feedback control systems. Now, we will continue our Nyquist stability analysis, but for the cases when there is a pole or poles on the imaginary axis. Okay, so the first assumption that we performed in this analysis is G of S has no poles or zeros on the imaginary axis. Okay, the basic idea is, in the Nyquist contour, there can't be any pole or zero. In this case, the stability analysis, even analysis, will be inapplicable. So what are we going to do is very simple. Instead of this wrong Nyquist contour, for this case, we will use a modified Nyquist contour. And what's a Nyquist contour is? Very simple. We will keep the basic structure as much as possible, and we will put a notch at the origin because we have a pole at the origin for this example. Okay, in this case, what are we going to do is, now this contour never crosses the pole, but it still covers all open relative plane. Okay, adding at this small little circle, we technically keep the basic properties of Nyquist stability analysis and Nyquist plot, but we need to technically solve the problem in the essence of this new notch. Okay, so let's assume that this is a Nyquist contour, and for a given G of S, we can have a Nyquist plot something like this. The first one, the mapping of the positive imaginary axis, is our polar plot. The second one is the mapping of the infinite dimensional half circle. The third one, which is technically the conjugate of the polar plot. And the fourth one, which is the new one, is the mapping of this new little circle. But as you can see in this example, this little circle is mapped to a large curve in the convex plane. And it is the case. In general, this infinitely small curve is mapped to infinite dimensional curves on the convex plane. For this reason, we need to be a little more careful when drawing the Nyquist plot when there's a pole at the origin. Okay. So this is an example, and the goal is finding the range of values of k, and k known to be 0, such that the closed loop system is stable. Okay, so this is a classic example that we solved previously, but the problem is now we have a pole at the origin, so we cannot apply the classical Nyquist contour. We need to use this modified Nyquist contour. Okay, so in this modified Nyquist contour, we have four paths, and we need to deal with all of them separately. Okay, let's start the first one, mapping of the j omega axis. G of j omega is equal to 1 over j omega plus 1, it is equal to minus 1 over omega squared plus 1, minus 1 over omega squared plus 1, j. Okay. So this is the real part, and this is the imaginary part. So, and we know that omega is greater than zero for this path. Okay, let's analyze this. We can see that real part is always less than zero because omega is positive, and imaginary part is also always less than zero. For this reason, in our Nyquist plot, we will not cover these regions. Okay? All of the plot will be, not Nyquist plot, but polar plot, so for that, will be in this quadrant. Okay, let's clean this. Okay, and also change this to this, no problem. Okay, so let's continue, and we can even change the color to a different color. Okay, so let's analyze what happens when we are going to zero on the frequency scale. Okay, we can see that real part is going to minus 1, whereas imaginary part is going to minus infinity. Okay, so what does it mean? It means that, so this is minus 1, and we know that it's a special point. And if we draw a line like this, and if j equals, our Nyquist plot will be somewhere here, right? Okay, and in this direction, omega is going to 0. Okay, so what happens when we are going to, and let's clean this, we have some space. when omega is going to infinity, okay, real part is going to zero, but imaginary part is also going to zero, so at infinity we will approach zero, okay? And Nyquist plot will look like something like this. Okay, indeed, if you look at the phase, g of j omega, it will approach to minus pi, so it will do this motion. Okay. So this is the polar plot that we already know from our first lecture. The second path is mapping of the infinite dimensional half circular part. Okay, so this is the polar plot, and in order to do that, we have a trick. S is equal to r times e to power j theta, and we know that r is vector. So if we look at g of s, or magnitude, we will see that it will be approximately equal to 1 over r squared, which is approximately equal to 0. Okay. So as usual, we know that this whole infinite dimensional half circle is mapped to a single point at the origin, so it's not really even critical to draw it on the map. Okay. The third part is the complex conjugate, but it has the same direction with the polar plot. So if we complete the polar plot, it will be something like this, and it will have the same direction. Okay, so this is in this direction, this is also in this direction. Okay. So as you can see, from 1 to 3, what's happening to our next plot? We start with minus infinite on the imaginary axis, we go to zero, and we go to infinity towards geometric axis. Okay, but as you can see, since we haven't covered 4 yet, Nyquist plot is not closed. Okay, in order to close it, we need to deal with this infinitesimal little notch. Okay, so okay, this is good. We know that. And this is good, we know that. Let's deal with this small notch. So we will do the same trick, and we write S in polar coordinates, epsilon e to power j phi. Okay, this is the notch. And we know that epsilon is technically little, it's small, it's going to zero. But phase is important. Phase starts from minus pi over 2, goes to pi over 2, in counterclockwise direction. In this case, direction is important. Okay, so be careful with the direction. Otherwise, your next plot can be wrong and your analysis can be wrong. Okay, let's look at the mapping. What are we going to do is g epsilon e to power j phi. Okay, and if you look at the details, we can easily see that it is equal to epsilon e to power j phi. Epsilon e to power j phi plus 1, this is equal to 1, technically, approximately. This is approximately equal to 1 over epsilon e to power j minus phi. Okay, so this is the magnitude, and phase is technically not the phase of this. And g s is approximately equal to 1 over epsilon. And phase of GS in this notch is approximately equal to, it's technically exact, okay, minus phi. Okay, so what is this? Epsilon is small, so technically this is infinite. Okay, so we have an infinite large curve here. So what is phi? Phi is going from minus pi over 2 to pi over 2 in counterclockwise direction. Because of minus, now we will move on clockwise direction, but from pi over 2 to minus pi over 2. So here, what are we going to do is very simple. We draw a large half circle. It doesn't matter if it's circle or not, but it's infinite dimensional. So this is, if this r, it's going to infinity. Okay, and it's in this direction. As you can see, whole Nyquist plot is in clockwise direction. Okay, but what is the Nyquist stability analysis? The good thing is, even if we don't notch, we can use the same stability analysis for analyzing these kind of special cases. Okay, so if you look at the closed circle, it's infinite dimensional but it's closed, it covers this region. And for stability analysis, the special point that we are interested in is minus 1, right? Okay. So for this case, the system is biostable. Okay. But let's remember, we draw the Nyquist plot of 1 over s times s plus 1, but we have k. So what are we going to do is, we need to draw the Nyquist plot with respect to k times s over s plus 1, which is simply the scale version. So nothing changes, only the like it will be bigger or smaller. But still, as you can see, this Nyquist plot never crosses the minus pi point as far as k is greater than 0. So our conclusion is, for this system, when k is equal to 0, the system is always biostable. Okay? So if you are careful with the notch, Nyquist stability analysis is not that hard. Let's try to verify this using the root talks techniques that we already know. Okay, so this is the system. So what are we going to do is, we need to draw the root locus. So we have a pole at the origin. We have a pole at minus 1. If we draw the root locus, we know that this is in the root locus. This is going in this direction. This is going in this direction. If you look at the breakaway point, we have a breakaway point at 0.5. One asymptote in pi over 2. One other asymptote minus pi over 2. And we can finalize root locus plot. And as you can see, when k is greater than 0, the system is stable.